Hello students, we will be talking about taxonomic categories today. Classification of living organism is not a single step process as mentioned in your book, but it involves hierarchy of steps and levels, and each level or each step is called a rank or a category. So classification of organism is not a simple process involving only one step. It is a part of overall taxonomic arrangement. So it is a systematic way in which organism is classified, and all these steps involve or all these categories or ranks together is called as taxonomic hierarchy. Each category of organism is referred to as unit of classification, and the group of organisms that is included in each category represents what is called as taxon. Now when we talk about these categories, for example, all the plants belong to this kingdom Plantae. We classify all plants and put them into or under a kingdom called as Plantae. Here kingdom is a category or a rank, and plants, all the plants included under this particular category kingdom, this group of plants or this group of living organism represent taxon. So when you classify an organism, you need to have a category and you need to have a taxon. So these are the two important necessities for classification. Now when you are assigning a place for the organism in a systematic method of classification, the basic necessity is you need to have a thorough knowledge of the category, of the characters of the organisms or the group of organisms. That is very important, because this knowledge helps you to identify the similarities and dissimilarities among the individuals. We have learned taxonomy or systematics involves classification of organisms based on similarities and differences. So when you have a thorough knowledge about the characteristics of the plants, of the organisms, the similarities of these organisms, the differences of the organism, then only it helps in systematic classification of organisms. Now when you classify the organism, the classification is in a hierarchical order, that is in an ascending order or in a descending order. Now when you classify an organism, there are different categories involved. Namely, kingdom, division, class, order, family, genus, species, all these are categories which are arranged in a particular sequence, in an hierarchical order. Hierarchy means from in the ascending order. Okay, so you have here in these particular categories, kingdom being the highest category and species being the lowest category. So when you classify the organism, you start with kingdom and you come down to the species. So that is how you classify, and each of these units are called as categories. Now these categories mentioned above, these are compulsory categories. So the examples of compulsory categories include kingdom, division, class, order, family, genus and species. They are essential when you classify the organism. Now besides these, there are certain other categories called as facultative categories, which involve or which include suborder, subfamily, subdivision and so on. This can be used as per the need of the taxonomist. If a particular group consists of many organism, then it is divided, that particular category is divided into its subpart. So you have lot of organisms in division, then you put you classify the organism, or you observe the organism with a particular similarities, they are then put into a into a facultative category called as the subdivision. In the method of classification, you require the two important necessity is a category and a taxon. Category is a rank, is a grade given to the organism, and I told you it's in the ascending it's in the ascending order. If you start with species and end with kingdom, because kingdom is at the highest, is the highest category, and species is the lowest category, or maybe in the descending manner if you start with kingdom and go down to species, either way. And what is a taxon? Taxon is a taxonomic group of any rank in the system of classification as mentioned in your textbook. This definition is given by H. J. Lamb in 1948. To make it simple, the group of organisms that come under each category represents a taxon. For example, we know that all plants are included under kingdom Plantae. So kingdom is the category and Plantae is the taxon. We have all animals included under kingdom Animalia. So here kingdom becomes the category and animals that included Animalia, it is the group of animals, so that include or that is called as the taxon. So taxon represents a group of organism in the unit of classification or in the system of classification. So you have in plant kingdom angiosperms, dicotyledoni, polypetale, malvaceae, as mentioned in your book, all these, each unit is called as a taxon. And the rank or the gradation is called as the category. We will see an example, children, over here. They have given you the example of classification of both plants as well as animal. They have given the classification of hibiscus and classification of naja. We will talk about this. So now, as seen in this particular table, you can see the categories in the hierarchical order. Beginning with kingdom, which is at the highest level, and species, which is at the lowest level. So you have, after kingdom is division, class, subclass, series, order, family, genus, and then finally species. Phylum is a category in the classification of animals, and division pertains to both plants as well as animals. Now if you take the example of hibiscus, the classification of hibiscus is China rose. It's called popularly called as China rose, or you call it as shoe flower or jaswanti. Kingdom is Plantae, okay, because they show characteristics of all plants having root, stem, leaves, etc. Hence they are included under the category kingdom. Division, angiosperm, because their fruit, the seeds are covered with a fruit. Hence, division is angiospermy. Class is dicotyledonic, because their seed show two cotyledons. Hence, they come under class dicotyledonic. Subclass polypetale, meaning their petals are free. They are not united. Hence, they come under subclass polypetale. Series, thalamiflorae. Now, you know the four whorls of the flower from the outer to the inner side. Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Now all these four whorls are present on the stalk of the flower called as pedicel. Now in the the apical part of the pedicel, children, the topmost part of the pedicel gets modified into a cup shaped or a saucer shaped structure called as thalamus. And inside this thalamus, all the four whorls of the flower are arranged in concentric manner. This thalamus, in some plants it is distinct, in some flowers it may not be very distinct. Whereas in case of hibiscus, thalamus is very distinct, shows a distinct thalamus, so it belongs to thalamiflorae. Series is thalamiflorae. Order is malvales, they belong to this particular order Malvilles because the ovary shows placentation, a particular type of placentation called as parietal placentation. Now, what is placentation? It is the arrangement of ovules inside the ovary. You know that within the ovary, the ovules are present, and in all different plants show different arrangement of ovules inside the ovary. For example, if you take lady's finger, the ovules are all present at the center. Okay, they show axial placentation. If you take example of pea, then the ovules are attached to the margin, that is called as marginal placentation. And in case of papaya, etc., it's attached to the wall of the ovary. Hence, it is called as parietal placentation. This particular plant belongs to order Malvilles because they show axial placentation. All the plants belonging to this particular order shows axial placentation. Family is Malvaceae because of the distinct characteristic feature of their flowers. The flowers show a single staminal tube. You might have seen the flower of hibiscus. They show a tube protruding out, and that is the characteristic features of family Malvaceae. There are a number of other characteristic features also. The shape of the anther, the position of the stigma, etc. They show pentacarpillary ovary, etc. So there are a number of characteristic features which makes them fall into this particular family Malvaceae. Genus is Hibiscus and species is Rosa sinensis. These are the two terms associated with binomial nomenclature, which includes the genus and the species. Coming to the next classification, it is about the classification of Naja Naja. Naja Naja is cobra. Okay, so the category kingdom is Animalia because this comes under kingdom Animalia. Division is Chordata because they show presence of chord, notochord at some stage of life. They even show presence of vertebral columns, so they they come under division or phylum Chordata. Then you have classes Reptilia, not here phylum. For higher organisms you have division. For lower organisms you have phylum Porifera, Coelenterata, etc. So the lower organisms, the non-chordate, show phylum, and the chordate show division. So here the division is Chordata. Class is Reptilia because they show dry epidermal scales present on their body, the main characteristic features of Reptilia. Subclass is Diapsida. Diapsida, they come under this particular subclass Diapsida because their skull shows two openings. Okay, within the skull there are two openings, one above the eye and one below the eye. The bones of the skull show these openings. Now, this openings are very important, very significant, because they help in attachment of very strong jaw muscles, and that helps them to open their mouth very widely so as to eat their prey. So they come under Diapsida subclass. Order is Scomata. They belong to this particular order Scomata because a scomata is derived from the word scomus epithelium. Scomus epithelium covers the outer part of your body. Even our body, the outer part of our body, the skin, is made up of squamous epithelium. This shows of a property of ecdysis or molting. Even our cells, old cells are thrown worn out periodically, and new cells come in come at its place. Whereas in these case of these animals, they show periodic molting of the entire skin. Okay, in case of this particular snakes, you might have seen it in Discovery Channel, etc. Most of the reptiles do. Some, the entire whole skin is thrown away. In lizards, etc., patches of skin they periodically remove. It is, there is wearing out of this periodical wearing out of a skin. So they come under this order, schemata. It's called as molting, or it's called as ecdysis. They belong to family Elaptidae, because these are the group of highly poisonous snakes, venomous snakes, and they show short fangs right in the front of their mouth, and they are able to inject venom into their prey and kill them. Genus is Naja. So that's about the classification of plant as well as an animal. And I hope by this example you understood what a category is. Category is a rank in the unit of classification. Kingdom is at the highest, is the highest category, the highest rank, and species is the lowest category or the lowest rank. So all this, the one which represents the rank or the gradation or steps is called as category. Whereas taxon represents the group of organism, the group of organisms included in a particular unit of classification or in a particular category represents what is called as taxon. So when you talk about taxon, these are the group of organisms, Plantae, Animalia, Angiospermae, Chordata, these all represents group of organisms showing similarities, hence put into a particular category, into a definite category. I hope you have understood this particular terms, category and taxon. We now go to the units of classification. Each one by one, beginning from the lowest category to the highest category. In the unit of classification, the lowest category is the species. Now, species, it is very important. It is, though it is the lowest category in the unit of classification, species, they include group of organisms which are morphologically similar, and they are able to interbreed with each other and produce fertile organisms under natural conditions. So these organisms, the organisms showing these similarities, they are able to mate with each other and produce fertile offsprings, they belong to a particular species. They as mentioned in your book, they initially thought that it is the lowest category which cannot be divided, but in modern taxonomy there are division of species also, such as subspecies. So depending on the population, etc., the species can be still divided into much smaller group, namely subspecies, etc. Now if you consider the example of Mangifera indica, or maybe Hibiscus rosa sinensis, Naja, then indica in case of Mangifera indica in case of Hibiscus rosa sinensis, and case of Naja, all these are called as species. Okay, they are very if you take indica includes group of organisms which are closely related to each other. They will show the same morphological characteristics, features. They'll show the same metabolic activities or main physiological activities, and they are able to interbreed with each other and produce fertile organisms. So you have indica, a species. You have rosa sinensis, a particular species, okay, including which include organisms which can interbreed with each other. A human being, we belong to the species sapiens, so we can interbreed with another sapien and produce fertile organism. The next unit of classification is genus. So genus is a category which is larger than species, and it is used in biological classification. Species is a genus is a group of species which bear close resemblance to one another in their morphological characters, but they cannot interbreed with each other. Okay, so you have for example, in your book they have given this example, tiger, leopard and lion. All these are three different species, but they belong to the same genus Panthera because of certain features which are similar to each other. Okay, some features which are similar to each other, hence they belong to the same genus Panther. But a tiger cannot mate with a leopard, or a leopard cannot mate with a lion and produce fertile organisms. Fine. Hence, that is what a genus is. So, genus is a group of species bearing close resemblance to one another in their morphological characters, but they cannot interbreed with each other. Another example of genus is Solanum. You have brinjal and potato, both coming under this particular genus Solanum. But brinjal and potato cannot interbreed them, you cannot hybridize them and produce a fertile organism. Coming to the next taxonomical hierarchy is taxonomical category is family. Family, you define it as it is a group of closely related genus, genera. Closely related genera is the example of is the definition of family. Now you have genera like hibiscus, gossypium, in which cotton comes. Then you have Cida, Bombax, all this belongs to the same family, Malvaceae, because of, their flowers show, I told you, they show that staminal tube, owing to the similarity in their, few similarities, they come under family Malvaceae. The other example they have given, cats, domestic cats as well as wild cats, they also belong to the family of leopards, tiger, lion. So the family is Felidae. Okay, Felidae. But you have leopards, tigers and lions coming under Panthera. You don't have cats coming there. But cats, they belong to this cat family. So family is Felidae. So you have wild cat, domestic cat, leopards, tigers, lions, all coming, cheetah, all coming under this particular family Felidae because of their, little similarities in their morphological characters. Dog belongs to another family, Canidae, where you have domestic dog, wild dog, all the different species, breeds of dogs. You have wolf, we have hyena, we have jackal, fox, all coming under Canidae. After phylum is order. Order is also called as cohort. Sometimes mentioned called as cohort, or sometimes mostly popularly called as order. So this is how will you define an order. An order is a group of closely related family which may show definite affinities. So much they may not show much resemblances, but a few characters which may be similar, hence they come under a particular order. So members belonging to the same order but different families may show very few similarities. It should be, children, you have to make a change over there. Very few similarities they show, not dissimilarities. They show very less similarities. So as you go higher, species more similarities, genus a little less, then your family little more less. So this similarities go on reducing, and finally kingdom Plantae will include very few characteristics, similarities. Similarities will be only that they show root, stem and leaves. Okay, the basic morphological structure they show, hence they come under kingdom Plantae. Fine. So as you go high from species to kingdom, the number of similarities become very, very less. So here they have given family Papaveraceae, Brassicaceae, Caparidaceae, all showing parietal placentation, and they are grouped under order Perittales. Order Perittales, I told you, we spoke about placentation. Malvaceae show exile placentation. All this plants, Papaveraceae, this is chilies, Brassicaceae, mustard, then Caparidaceae, example, I'll have to find out, but Papaveraceae is you have chilies coming under that, then Brassicaceae is mustard, cabbage, radish, all comes under Brassicaceae. All this show what is called as parietal placentation, where the ovules are attached to the wall of the fruit, hence they come under this order Perittales. Families of dog and cats, although they are very different, they belong to the same order Carnivorous, because they feed on other animals for their that is their mode of nutrition. Then coming to class, class also is a distinct taxonomic rank with its own with its own significance, ant, how will you define a class? Class is the assembly of closely related orders. It's an assemblage of closely allied orders, means closely related orders form what is called as class. And you have carnivora and primates, both coming under mammalia, because they show mammal-like characteristics, having fur on their body, females showing mammary glands, feeding their young ones, etc. So you have monkeys, gorillas, gibbons, all these are primates. You have dogs, cats, tigers, they belong to carnivora, but since they show few characteristics which are similar to them, to each other, they come under this class mammalia. Then you have division of phylum. This is a group of related classes. So you have angiospermae, this particular division including two classes, dicotyledons and monocotyledons. And I told you, in case of animals, the subunit is phylum. In lower non-chordates, you classify them into phylums. So you have learned last year phylum Porifera, Coelenterata, or Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes, Aeschylminthes, etc. And in higher higher animals, you have division as the unit of classification. Then you have subkingdom, where different divisions come together having some similarities, they will form subdivision. So you have angiospermae and gymnosperma coming under phanerogams. Phanerogams are flowering plants. Angiosperms and gymnosperms are way apart from each other. They've got a lot of differences. Fine. But since they are flowering plants, they are put under phanerogams. And kingdom, as I told you, is the highest unit of unit of classification. It is the highest taxonomic category, which is composed of many subkingdoms. You have subkingdoms, phanerogams and cryptogams, which form the plant kingdom. Phanerogams, flowering plants, and cryptogams are the non-flowering plants. So you have algae, fungi, pteridophyta, bryophyta, all coming under cryptogams. So they belong to these are the subkingdoms that belong to plant kingdom or kingdom plantae, whereas all the animals, the chordates and the non-chordates, are all included under kingdom animalia. So this taxonomic categories, they are broad categories, they are compulsory, I told you, but there are many subcategories also. Scientists have added the subcategories to place organisms in a more scientific manner, so that their study becomes more meaningful, their study becomes more easy, and people are able to relate with the organisms, study them in a better way, I'm repeating the same thing, I'm so sorry. So as mentioned, as I already told you, you will observe that as you go higher in the taxonomical ladder, that is from the species to the kingdom, the number of common characters will go on decreasing. Fine. So species will have more of common characters. Genus, usse kam. Then family, lesser than that. Order, fine. So as you go high from the descending to the ascending order, from the lowest category to the highest category, the number of common characters or the number of similar characters will go on decreasing. Okay, children. With that, we finish off with the units of classification. Nomenclature and all, I have already discussed with you. We will go to the next chapter in the next lecture. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. Goodbye.